So next question in the design, consider the following statements regarding a Grillage foundation. Okay, what is a Grillage foundation? We will see that. So it is provided for heavily loaded isolated columns. Okay, and it is treated as a spread foundation. It consists of two sets of perpendicularly placed steel columns. Okay. So here, first of all, we will see what is the foundation and what is the grilled foundation in that. Generally, you know, foundation is like for any building or any structure, you know, the foundation should be made, you know, at the bottom. So the foundation, you know, there are generally two types of foundation. One is the shallow and the other one is the depth foundation. So the selection of either of these two foundation is depending on the soil type and the groundwater table. If soil type is very strong, then we will go for the shallow. Shallow means the depth of the foundation is not that much, you know, high. But whereas if the soil is very weak, then we need to go for the very, you know, depth, and based on the loads also and site conditions, like whether you know so much of space is available or not, or environment and economical also. Okay, if you go for the depth foundation, even for the simple one, then you need to put more money on the foundation than the actual building. Okay, so we need to consider all these issues. So among all these, you know, Grillage foundation, what is the Grillage foundation? It is a, you know, one of the types in the shallow foundation. Okay, so see, if you look at this picture, so this is a Grillage foundation. So this is a concrete, this is a concrete pad, and on the concrete we have a steel grills, steel beams like this. Okay, see, if you look at this, this is a, like, you know, in this direction, and on this another steel tire pair of set of steel beams which are perpendicular to the previous one, and here also we have one more steel pair, and that is perpendicular to the below one. And if you observe, this is the cement, and here also it is the cement. See, this is also cement. That means, you know, all these steel plates are, you know, connected through the cement and which are perpendicular to the each other. And what is this? This is a column. Okay, so from it, you know, the main purpose of this foundation is to take the loads transmitted by these columns here. Okay, so here, if you, you know, read this, it is generally used at the base of the column, and it consists of two or more types of steel beams superimposed on a layer of concrete. Okay, that is what it is. Here also concrete, and at the top also we got a concrete, and these are placed at right angles to each other, and all are encased in the concrete. And generally it is used when the load is heavy but the soil capacity is not enough to make it. Okay, so in that case, how it is a, you know, taking, even in that case when the soil is not strong enough to take this load. See, here if you see, the base, concrete base is very very spread out. It is a spreading like this, you know, it is a spreading this much area, and here also this much length and this much, so that it is covering so much of area. Okay, so even though it is not going that much deep into the, you know, earth, but it is a spreading. So what is happening? So whenever the force is transmitted through the column to this foundation, then, you know, it has enough area to distribute its force. Okay, that is how it is working here. And see, it is a shallow foundation because of this spreading concrete foundation. Okay, these are the points about this. Okay, and there are different types of other foundations also, but we will stop here with the Grillage foundation because that is what asked here. So if you go back and read the points again, so it is provided for heavily loaded isolated columns, yes, and it is treated as a spread foundation, yes. Why? If you take the concrete pad, it is you know, occupying so much of area, so we can treat it as a you know, spread foundation. And it consists of two sets of perpendicularly placed steel columns. Steel columns, okay. So here, see, these are steel. They are placed, you know, perpendicular to each other. Okay. So what is the option? Option is 1, 2, 3, all the above. And the next question is, the process of next question is the process of removing irregular portions of a stone and facilitating their easy transportation is known as, okay, so quarrying, reticulating, dressing and pounding. There are different options and we will understand each and everything. So what is the quarrying? Quarrying is a easy one. The process of extraction of suitable stones from their natural rock beds or layers is commonly called as a quarrying. Okay, so many quarries, you know, you might have seen, you know, whenever they do mining. So mining is nothing but a quarrying also. And what is the dressing here? In the dressing, see, for example, you mined this type of granite stone here. But these stones are of irregular shapes. And if you want to transport this shape, then it is not so easy. So what we do is we will make these these stones, quarried stones, into the proper desired shapes so that it is easy to transport and then it is also suitable for this manufacturer. So here the stone after being quarried are to be cut into suitable sizes and with suitable surfaces. Okay, this process is called as the dressing of the stone. And why we are doing the dressing of the stone? It makes the transport from the quarry easy and economical. Okay, and it is also useful to get the desired appearance from the stonework. Okay, and then another one is reticulating. Even you might have found these type of design on the pavement also, you know, walkways. So varieties of finishes can be obtained by dressing. See, generally we are doing, you know, this army is doing a dressing for the stone, and if the design is finished net like appearance, if the dressing of the stone is designed as like a net like appearance, then it is called as a reticulating. Okay, and what is the other term that we use? Pointing. See, these are all these things we know, whatever we are discussing, but we don't know its technical names. That is only different. So what is the pointing? Pointing, see, for example, if you see any wall like this, then there is a gap between these walls. See, you can see here also a gap between these walls. So what happens, this gap, see, if you don't fill this gap properly, then whenever rainwater comes, especially the walls, outside walls, then the rainwater will go inside and then it will make them weaker. Okay, so the pointing is here the finishing of the mortar joints in a brick or a stone masonry construction. Okay, generally we will do with the cement. Okay, so these are the four words that are coined in this question. So which one is appropriate here? The process of removing irregular portions of stone and facilitating their easy transportation is nothing but dressing here. Okay, so next question is, pneumatic structure is a membrane structure and stabilized by compressed air, characterized by internal pressure being less than, internal pressure PI is a less than P atmosphere. That is what they are saying here. Okay, and it is characterized by internal pressure being equal to or more than the external pressure. So here, instead of less than, it is a greater than or equal to P naught. Okay, so we need to choose appropriate options. So first of all, what is the pneumatic structure? See, whenever you use the pneumatic term, that means we are using the air here. Air. So by using the air, you want to create a structure. How it is possible? So you might have seen these type of structures, especially kids are playing in parks and some other places, and this is also one type of pneumatic structure. So here, to inflate this structure with the air, what happened? We need to send compressed air, then only it will overcome the outside pressure, atmospheric pressure, then it will create this type of a structure. To create this type of structure, okay, we have this plastic thing here. So this is also called as the, it could be either plastic or whichever material you use, generally light material. Then air should be able to inflate this when you send the, you know, compressed air into it. So this is called as the membrane here, okay, membrane. So for a, so you know, pneumatic structure is a system of component that is supported by air in the same manner a balloon is supported by the air. And what are the different components in this membrane? For example, this you can see membrane and supporting cable sometimes, okay, you can keep supporting cable sometimes. And the anchoring system, anchoring means, you know, you inflated this and if you don't anchor, then what happened? It will fly away. So some anchoring system will be there here, okay, and here also some anchoring system will be there. And then HVAC system, what is the HVAC? H stands for heating, V stands for ventilation, AC stands for air conditioning, okay. Why? See, for example, this membrane is not so tight, that means it is not totally sealed one. Some of the air may, you know, go into the atmosphere and there will be a pressure loss in this, okay. And to maintain that, you know, we will keep this HVAC system so that whenever there is a decrease in the pressure or decrease in the air, then automatically it will regulate the system and, you know, pump in a required amount of the air here, okay. So here, so I explained everything. And see, when will this membrane will be inflated? Only when the pressure inside this membrane can overcome the outside pressure or atmospheric pressure, okay. So here, if you look at the third statement, the characterize, it is a pneumatic structure is characterized by internal pressure being less than the external pressure. That means Pi is less than the P naught, okay. This is wrong. Third one is wrong. And fourth one is correct. And the pneumatic structure is having the membrane structure, okay. And it is stabilized by compressed air, okay. Why, what is the meaning of compressed air? If you want to increase the pressure of the air, then you need to compress it, okay. You need to compress it, air. You need to compress, then only, you know, its pressure will increase. So, except 3, 1, 2, 4 are correct. So, option is B here.